In today's class, I would like to discuss about characteristics of computers. Okay, all of you, I would like to remind you one thing. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you are not clicking on the subscribe button, you will not get the notifications about my videos without intimation. So, my request is, please do subscribe and click on the bell icon also. Okay, I will start my topic. So, our topic name is characteristics of computers. So these are also called as features of the computers. In the last videos I discussed about applications of computers, means where we are using the computers in the real time. These are nothing but qualities of the computers, properties of the computers, or functions of the computers. Okay, features of the computers. So coming to the characteristics of computers, first I will write down some of the important points. So note it down. After that, one by one I will explain. Okay. So coming to the characteristics of computers, no need to remember in the same order. Just we are discussing about features of computers. Okay. So number one is speed. Number two is accuracy. Number three is reliability. Number four is diligence. Number five, large storage capacity. Number six, versatility. Number seven, easy maintenance. Number 7. Number 8. Networking capacity. Number 9. Programmable. Number 10, compactness. Don't worry about all these topics, I will explain one by one. Okay, compactness, cost effectiveness. Okay, and source of entertainment. Automation. So these are some of the features of the computers. If you write down the list, so I mean every feature of the computer we are using in the real time, we will get so many features. So up to we are discussing some of them. Okay, I will explain now. I will explain one by one. So keep it handy. I will continue the explanation of number one, speed. All the features of the computers or characteristics of the computers one by one. Okay, the first characteristics of the computer is speed. The speed of the computer is very high. Okay, the computer can process millions of instructions in fraction of seconds. So generally the speed of the computer will be measured in nanoseconds. Nanosecond means 10 power minus 9 seconds. Or picoseconds, 10 power minus 12 seconds. So the computer can process millions of instructions in fraction of seconds. So accuracy means exactness. How our computer is giving the results, very accurately it is giving. But whenever the user is entering the wrong input, the computer might give wrong results. Why? Because user has given wrong input. For example, if you want to get the result, whenever the student is getting the result, if you want to check the result, he has to supply the correct alt ticket number. If he is supplying the correct, wrong alt ticket number, the computer cannot give the result. So depending on the user input, sometimes the computer might give wrong results. It is not because of the computer mistake, it is because of human mistake. So whenever the user is supplying the valid data, the computer is going to give the results very accurately. Okay, so the computers are giving the results very accurately. Accuracy means exactness. Okay, that is the second property of the computer. And third one, reliability. Reliability means belief. It means belief. So we can believe the computer results with more confidence. Why? Because the computer is always giving the accurate results, as we discussed in the previous point. Whenever the computer is giving the accurate results, obviously we can believe the computer results with more confidence. And I will explain what is reliability with respect to real-time scenario. For example, you are going to the office or college, okay, or you are going on the road. Suddenly some unknown person came before you and he is offering the juice for you. Will you take it? Obviously not. Why? Because he is unknown person. How can you believe him? Yes or no? But on the same way, if your mother is coming on the spot, on that moment, and if she is offering the juice, what you will do? Obviously you will take it. Why? Because she is your mother. So whenever, our mother is giving the juice, so we can believe her with more confidence. Similarly, we can believe the computer results with more confidence. Why? Because the computer always giving correct results. Okay, so that is called as reliability of the computer. Reliability means we can believe the computer results with more confidence. Computer results with more confidence. So it is called as reliability property of the computer. Coming to the fourth one, diligence. What is the meaning of diligence? It is nothing but the computer can work continuously 24/7, 365 days. For example, while you are making online transactions, the bank servers are always on. So even though it was night 12 o'clock or 2 p.m., so you can do your operation. In the bank server, there is no person operating the bank server. So without human environment, so the server is going to give the response. How it is possible? Because the computer is running continuously. But what is the meaning of diligence property? The computer can work continuously without getting any bore. The computer doesn't get any feeling of boring. The computer doesn't get any feeling of tiredness. The computer never gets frustration like a human being. For example, if any person is telling the work to you continuously, you will get the irritation immediately. But the computer will not get any irritation. The computer doesn't get any frustration. Okay, so that property is called as diligence. Diligence is nothing but the computer doesn't have any feeling of boring. Doesn't get frustration. Like human being, and doesn't get the feeling of tiredness. Even though it is working for 24 hours continuously, the computer never feels it got tired. Am I correct? So that property is called as diligence. Doesn't get feeling of tiredness. This property is called as diligence. Okay, coming to the fifth property. Large storage capacity. Large storage capacity. For example, if the student want to store the books, you are taking the bag. Is it or not? If you want to keep your laptop, you need a container whose name is bag. So similarly, the computers are able to store the large amount of data. Huge amount of data it can store. Where it is storing? It is storing the data in the hard disks. Okay? In the hard disk, it can store large amount of data. The data can be in terabytes or petabytes, exabytes, like this. Okay? So the computers are having large storage capacity. But whereas a human being is not having that much storage capacity. Why? Because we don't have the strong memory power. For example, can you tell me what curry your mother prepared in the last year, same day? Can you tell the answer? Obviously not. But if you are storing the data in the computer, even after 10 years, if you ask the data, you can get it back. How it is possible? Because of its storage capacity. We are storing the data in the hard disks. Whenever you want, you can take it. Okay? But human being can forget sometimes. But the computer is not forgetting. One time if you delete the file, that file will be deleted. Okay? So the conclusion is, the computers are having large storage capacity. Where it is getting stored? Our data will be stored in the secondary storage device like hard disks, pen drives, etc. Okay? So that is called as large storage capacity. Its capacity can be measured in, similarly, megabytes. Memory capacity can be measured in megabytes, gigabytes, 1 GB data, 2 GB data, like this. Similarly, terabytes, petabytes, exabytes, jetabytes, petabytes, like this. So this is the largest memory. I mean, Google servers are maintaining such type of hard disks, which are able to store petabytes of information. Okay, so the computers can store huge amount of data. That is called as large storage capacity. Okay, number 6. Versatility. Versatility means the computer is able to do many tasks at a time. It is able to perform many operations at a time. That property is called as versatility. For example, after opening the computer, what you are doing? You can prepare your resume to apply for the jobs. You can listen a song parallelly. You can open the website. If your computer is having internet connection, you can open the website. You can open multiple websites at the same time. You can play the game. So the same computer is able to do these many operations at a time. That property is called as versatility. What is the meaning of versatility? The ability to do many operations at a time. Okay? Where our computer is doing many operations at a time. That property is called as versatility of the computer. Okay? Now we will go for the next property. So, the conclusion of the versatility is the ability to do many operations. Okay? I mean, example, you can write, listen a song. You can listen a song at the same time. You can prepare your resume. Okay? Similarly, at the same time, you can open the website. The same time, you can play the game. You can open multiple websites on the same browser. So, at a time, in the same computer, you are able to do all these operations. As you are able to do many operations at a time, that property is called as versatility. Okay? As computer is having these features, as it is able to do all these operations at a time, this property is called as versatility. Versatility means the ability to do many operations at a time. Okay? So, coming to the next property, easy maintenance. The name itself meaning is, the computers are easy to maintain. Why they are easy to maintain? The computers are easy to maintain. For example, if any component of the computer is getting damaged, we can replace that part without disturbing the remaining components. For example, if the keyboard is not working, so we can replace that keyboard, just it is enough. So the computers are easy to maintain. Okay, that feature is called as easy maintenance. The computer parts can be easily repairable. Okay, that property is called as easy maintenance. So coming to the conclusion, easy maintenance means the computer parts are easily repairable and even if you replace one of the component of the computer, it is not disturbing the remaining components. Okay? So, easy to repair, I already wrote, easy to repair, easy to replace the parts. easy to replace the damaged parts. Easy to replace the damaged parts. And the cost of the computer nowadays, it is very less when compared to the olden days. Okay. So this property is called as easy maintenance. And next property, networking property or networking capability or networking capacity. So the new word networking means what? It is a group of computers connected together to share the information. That is called as network. The main purpose of network is to share the information from one computer to another computer. So then we need a network. One computer want to communicate with another computer. If one computer want to communicate with another computer, we need a network. A network is required. It is similar to friendship between two friends. Okay. So it is a link between two computers. Whenever the link is established, the computer is able to communicate with another computer. That property is called as network. The main purpose of network is to share the information from one computer to another computer. As we are seeing internet is a big network. We can send the email to any person, whoever is staying in the world. Okay, so internet is the largest network which is able to connect all the computers in the world, which is having the net connection. So the computers are able to support the networking property, so that we can share the information from one system to another system. This property is called as networking capacity or networking capability. Okay, as the computer is supporting networking feature, we are saying that it is a networking capability of the computer. Coming to the next property, programmable. Programmable means in the computer, for example, if you want to play the game, some software is required. If you want to open the calculator in the computer, so calculator is also a program. If you want to listen to a song or if you want to watch the movie, some player softwares are required, like VLC player, Windows Media Player. So media player means what? It is a software which is able to play the videos. Similarly, if you want to do any operation in the computer, we need some softwares. What is the meaning of software? Software is having set of programs. Program is having set of instructions. So every program is a set of instructions. If you group some instructions, it is called as program. For example, if you are using C language, in C language we are writing a programs. That is called as programming language. So what is the meaning of program? It is a group of some instructions. Okay, the instruction is also called a statement. To do a task, whatever the statements we are writing in the program, combinedly we are calling it as a program. Program contains set of instructions where every instruction is able to do some task. For example, if you want to add two numbers in the calculator. So calculator program, if you take calculator program, what it is having? Suppose you have to supply the two numbers. Let us say 50 and 80. And if you are clicking on the plus button, what internally happening? So plus is activating the addition program, so that it is able to do the addition. So internally it is doing some calculation, it is giving the result as 130. How it was done? Internally some program was there inside the calculator, some program was fed into chip. Okay, that program is able to do this operation. What program contains? Instructions which are used to perform that operation. So in the computer, by using computer, we can able to write so many programs. If you group some programs, it is called a software. Okay, so in the computer, as in the computer, we can develop many programs. So it is having the feature as programmable. It is also called as characteristics of the computer. Why? Because by using computer, we can write some programs. Okay, by using program, what we can do? We can do a task. We can do a work also. That is, work is also called as task. So if you group some programs, it is called as software. For example, if you see WhatsApp, every application in the Play Store, it is also a software. So it is having some set of programs. Okay, the feature is called as programmable. Coming to the next feature, compactness will be discussed with respect to size of the computer. In the olden days, the computer occupied the entire room. But nowadays, we can accommodate the tablet PCs into our hand. See how the size of the computers was reduced from olden days to recent days. So the size of the computer is very small. Okay, whenever the size is very small, it will occupy very less space in the offices. Is it or not? So nowadays, for example, in the olden days, the people might have used desktop computers with CRT monitors that occupies very huge space in the offices. But nowadays, the CRT monitors are replaced by the LCD monitors. LCD monitors will occupy very less space. Even nowadays, to the same monitor only, the small CPU are attached. Small CPU is attached and its size is completely like a single monitor. So to the monitor, a component will be fixed that is acting like a CPU. See how the size of the computer was reduced. In the olden days, the size of the computer was, it is occupying the entire room. But nowadays, we can accommodate the computer into our hand. Even our mobile is also like a mini computer, acting like a mini computer. Okay, so the compactness means the size of the computer is very small, so that in the offices they can establish the computers very easily. Why? Because it is occupying very less space. That property is called as compactness. Compactness means with respect to size, the size of the computer is very small. Okay, that is called as compactness. Coming to the next property, cost effectiveness. Cost effectiveness means with respect to hardware. Nowadays the cost of the hardware parts is very less, and moreover it is saving the lot of hard copy paperwork, a lot of paper cost it is reducing. Why? Because in the computer, for example, if you see one book which is having 1000 pages, if you give the printout 1000 pages, you are wasting unnecessarily. Means in the computer, through soft copy, we are saving lot of paper, so that we are saving the environment also. So for the company, the cost of the paper will be reduced. So it is also saving the cost of maintenance cost for the company, as well as the computer parts also nowadays they are available with less cost. Okay, that property is called as cost effectiveness. It will reduce the maintenance cost for the company as well as the ordinary user also, who is using the personal computers and laptops. Okay, this is called as cost effectiveness. And the main property, characteristics of computers, and your favorite, that is source of entertainment. Okay, that is also called as source of entertainment. Source of entertainment means in the computer, you can play the game, you can listen the song, you can watch the movie. All this comes under entertainment only. So in the computer, you are able to listen the songs as well as you can watch the movies, you can play the games, you can prepare the documents. You can use the computer as a entertainment source also. Okay, through all your family members can watch the movie by sitting before the computer. So it is acting like a source of entertainment. Okay, coming to the automation property, automation means a machine which works itself without any human involvement is called as automation, automatic machine. Okay, for example, a machine which is able to work itself without any human involvement . So a machine which is able to work itself without any human involvement is called as automation property of the computer. For example, if you observe the bank servers, they are running continuously 24/7, 365 days. So because of the as servers are running continuously, we are able to do net banking operations very easily. Even the bank was closed, no problem for the user. He can do the transaction at any time. So that is because of the computer is working continuously without any human involvement. Even sometimes human effort may be required, but less human effort may be required sometimes. Okay. So anyway, a machine which is able to work itself without any human involvement is called as automation. As the bank servers are running continuously without any human involvement, so that is also called as automation property of the computer. So these are the features of computers or characteristics of the computers. And I would like to tell you two more points before ending the session. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you are not subscribing, if I am not giving intimation, definitely you will not get my whenever I am uploading my videos, you will not get the information. So my sincere request is, please click on the subscribe button and click on the bell icon also. Okay, so that you will get the notifications from time to time whenever I uploaded a new video. So you will be coming to know immediately. Okay, don't forget. Okay, do subscribe. And if you have any opinions or if you want more videos from me, please post it in the comment section. You are expecting so and so videos, so that I will post in the future videos. Okay, in the last video I discussed about the computer definition and characteristics of the computer. Okay, and C++ structure of the C++ program also, you can watch it. Okay, right.